Hello and welcome to this demonstration. Here, let's see how an API called Stock Alert, designed to send a message alert on Outlook if the stock of any coffee variety drops below the set limit after processing a new order request, can be created using App Connect Designer. Let's begin by clicking on Create a Flow for an API. Here, we can name our API. Let's call it Stock Alert API and name our model Order. Upon clicking Create Model, we can add properties to our model. We'll add properties for the coffee varieties that are ordered, Robusta, Arabica, and Excelsa, along with the ID and assign them to their appropriate types. Moving to the Operations tab, choose Create Order. Now let's click on Implement Flow. We're now in the API Flow Editor, where we see our request and response nodes. The request node displays our request object, and we can view sample data and regenerate it if needed. Next, let's add our first node from the toolbox menu, Set Variable. Here, let's set the email ID, which we will be sending the alert to, and the alert variable, which is the restocking limit. Let's give them their appropriate values. Next, let's add another node, the JDBC connector. Here, we'll input a custom query to update our inventory database with the new order details. We can choose available mappings to map the ordered values in. This query subtracts the ordered coffee amounts from the existing stock levels. Now, let's add another JDBC node, and this time add a custom query to select all the existing stock levels from our inventory. Next, let's add in a JSON parser to format the data, providing it the right data structure and generating the right schema. Now let's add the for each node to process each coffee variety. Again, here we can use the mapping data to get the output data from the JSON parser. Let's now add an if node inside of the for each block to check if any updated coffee stock levels drop below the alert value set. If this condition is met, we'll add a Gmail connector to send an alert via email to the inventory manager, prompting them to consider restocking. Let's provide the email ID, subject, and the HTML content we wish to add to the alert email and use the available mapping to map the dynamic stock values. Once the message is set and all email details are filled in, we can move on to the response node to define the response object with our coffee varieties and ID. Now that our flow is complete, the Done button is enabled, allowing us to test the API. Clicking Done, we're directed to the page displaying our models. At the header, the Start API button is now enabled. Let's click on Start to test our API. As the flow starts, the Test tab appears, offering the Try It feature for testing purposes. Scrolling down, we find the Generate button. After generating sample data and tweaking it, we can send the request and view the results. Let's now head over to our mailbox to find our alert. The message notifies us that Arabica coffee stocks are under the set limit, providing valuable inventory information. This demonstration highlights the ease with which APIs can be created and tested using App Connect. Thank you for joining us in this exploration of API creation using IBM App Connect.